Next to it is a French farmhouse that you would see in the French countryside, and that is the home of Denzel Washington. Yeah, he just purchased a home up in Malibu. Of course, Denzel Washington, he made a lot of money from his latest movie, Deja Vu. To your immediate left, lived Doris Day. Does anyone recognize her home from some of her movie scenes, Pillow Talk with James Gardner? Well, today Doris Day lives up in Carmel. Carmel is also the home to actor Clint Eastwood. Straight ahead behind the security gates is where the movie stars live. They do not like to see the tour buses in there, so we're going to come in from the back way, and by the time they call the cops, we're going to be out of there. To your right is a very sharp curve that's known as a dead man's curve. That's where Jan and Dean lost his life one Saturday afternoon. He took the curve too fast in his sports car and lost it. You might notice traffic along here on Sunset Boulevard real heavy. That's because Sunset is the major highway between the movie studios and Malibu. Your immediate left, the home of Robert Redford. To your immediate left, the home of Charles Bronson. He lost his wife a while back. He looks kind of quiet in there. To your immediate left, Danny DeVito. Immediate left. Today, Danny DeVito is a movie producer. That's where the big money is at, if you can produce a good movie. To your immediate left, the home of Elizabeth Taylor. Immediate left, the home all covered up with gingerbread. Just like Elizabeth Taylor. She spends a lot of her time down here in San Diego. She owns a condominium overlooking the city and harbor of San Diego. To your immediate right, the home of Brad Pitt and Angela Jolie. Yeah, very private. Well, sometimes they like to walk around with hardly any
clothes
on. Immediate left, the home of Dean Martin. Immediate left, one song made him rich and famous, Us Amore. Dean Martin raised a couple of fine sons from this home. One became an Air Force pilot, lost his life over Palm Springs. That was years ago. Today, singer Tom Jones living right here in the former home of Dean Martin. To your immediate left, a brand new home at George Clooney. George Clooney, immediate left. He just moved in here 8 months ago. He paid $60 million for this home. $60 million. Anyone ever heard of a Nicolas Cage? That's the big, beautiful home of Nicolas Cage. Right. It looks like a plantation-style home outside of Atlanta. Then to the right, Walter Matthau. That looks like a ghost house. Carry on, get out of here. Now, right in front of us, the home of the Reagans, Ronald and Nancy Reagan, right in front of us. Mr. Reagan passed away, but Mrs. Reagan, Nancy, she's still living here. It's a 40-acre estate. Yeah. You're going to notice the guardhouse right next to the driveway where Mr. Reagan kept the guard on duty. And there's that security camera looking at us. Joining me to the left, the home of actress Goldie Hawn, immediately left. Goldie Hawn, Kurt Russell. Goldie Hawn has a daughter by the name Kate Hudson. She's an actress also. We saw her a couple of weeks ago walking her dog along here. To your immediate right, the home of Alfred Hitchcock. You might notice a couple of his birds, one on each side of the driveway. Alfred Hitchcock. Anyone ever heard of a Paris Hilton?
Oh, yeah.
Okay, there's the home of Paris Hilton at the end of the street to your immediate left. It's off limits to the public in here. And to your immediate left is the home of actor Tom Cruise, immediate left. Tom Cruise. Yeah, he spends a lot of his time in Italy. And to your immediate left, the brand new home, Jerry Lewis. Jerry Lewis, the actor and comedian. Yeah, this home was built 8 years ago at a cost of $40 million. And right here in the corner, the home of Sean Connery. Sean Connery, right. Yeah, he did the real world for just having a high school education. Folks, right here is your immediate left, John Travolta. Boy, that gate has more class than his home. Oh, right, there's his home up there, that brick house. Right here behind the bushes on the corner is Nick Nolte. He could have been a famous movie star. What happened? He took the wrong turn off and he ended up on alcohol and drugs. The one private security force headquarters, Jerry, he made it left. Jerry made it right on the corner of the home of Priscilla Presley. She used to be married to Elvis, and she came from Memphis, Tennessee also. Next home to the right is the home of Michael, Michael Douglas, Jerry, made it right. He lives just around the corner from his dad. Immediate right is the home of Harrison Ford, witness Indiana Jones. Immediate right is a real private person. We never see him. He keeps his airplane down here at the Santa Monica Airport. Has anyone ever heard of a Bo Bridges, Jeff Bridges? He starred in that movie, Tucker Automobile. Well, right here, to your immediate left, the home of Jeff Bridges. Hey, guess what? His home, I see his black Mercedes been in the driveway. To your immediate right, the home of actor Tom Hanks. Yeah, he moved here a year ago from the Palisades, Tom Hanks. Coming up to your right is the home of Bugsy Siegel, the largest home on the block, home of Bugsy Siegel. Yeah, he was a mobster. He's the one that helped build Las Vegas. And guess what? He was murdered in his living room by one of the mob. It happened right here. And here's the home of Stephen the Smuggler to the right. And he's a copywriter, also a movie producer. He earned an Oscar for Schindler's List. You might have seen him several months ago. He was in front of the television cameras. That big house across the street from the River Young, the home of actor Chevy Chase. The next home coming up, the home of Gregory Peck. He was born and raised down here in San Diego. Gregory Peck. His ancestors come from Spain. He lived in the Spanish. That was a Spanish stucco home. Again, as I cross this intersection, if you look to your left behind you, you'll have a nice view to the famous Beverly Hills Hotel.
Located right here in the Forest Paramount area of Beverly Hills.
You might notice the beautiful white ash trees along here. Every one of these trees imported from Australia years ago in 5-gallon buckets. I noticed some of these homes along here because often a movie producer will come down here and he will pay the homeowner a handsome fee to go in there and shoot some movie scenes. They will rearrange the furniture or sometimes bring in furniture from the movie studios. That's because each one of these homes along here is a custom-built home. There's no two homes that look alike.
Gentle.